showing us how to stay cool and fashionable this summer with the most adorable DIY summer sun hats is Orly. So excited about this.
They are so cute and they're so happy. What I think is really great about this is that it can be completely customized and personalized to your style, to the colors you want to wear this summer, whatever the prints and the trends are that you're into, you can make your own custom hat. I think that's
I love customizing things. I mean, I think it's great because you're able to bring out some of your personality.
Yeah.
But the other part, of course, is that it's very important because of the sun.
Yeah. But you also love a straw hat. You have rocked a straw hat on
many seasons. I've rocked a hat on Amazing Race.
On many seasons of Amazing Race.
Yeah, this is actually in Bahrain. That's in Tunisia. I like to wear a hat that's in Cartagena in Colombia. For me, it really came down to a practical thing because I had so much stuff cut off my face, so many sunspots working outside for 30 years. And my doctor was like, you got to wear a hat. And then it became, okay, well, if I'm going to wear a hat, I want it to be,
cool.
I want it to have personality.
One hat? Did that same hat carry you through or did you have to replace it?
Well, I'm in the midst of getting a new hat and I'm gonna have a little stitching on the side that says the world is waiting for you, just like a nice little feature, you know, which is the thing I say at the start of Amazing Race. So that's why I'm excited about this because I think my wife and daughter are gonna get some inspiration.
We could also Mod Podge a thing or two on that hat.
We could.
Mod Pod?
You're gonna learn a thing.
See.
Watch.
You'll
Mod
see.
Mod Podge is one of the most amazing
it's
things.
It's not something I say every day.
No.
You know, Mod Podge.
But by the end of the segment, you'll understand what it is because that is one of the materials we need. We need a matte, depending on the hat that you have, not the glossy, but the matte Mod Podge.
Okay, and then you need Mod Podge.
Mod Podge. Okay. I know. I used to call it Mod Podge.
Okay. Everybody does. It's more fun to say.
Exactly.
That
and then we need fabric. Now, the fabric is entirely dependent on whether you want to go through your craft closet and pull out scraps that you have that you can use or going and buying something new. Now, what you can see that I've done is for both fabrics here, I cut out basically what starts to feel like little individual patches.
Okay.
Because what you want to do is when you're looking for the fabric, if it's going to be something like this, you want something that you can, it looks as though you could cut individual pieces from, not something that's so intensely woven that if you started cutting it would unravel. Exactly.
Right.
Or something like this, which is really fun. It's got so many different things. It's got butterflies and flowers, but each one's kind
is
of
that
in
a curtain or a tablecloth?
No, it's just fabric. It's just fabric that we had here. But
is your house full of collectible things where you just are grabbing bits and pieces?
True.
Yes,
I'm just trying to think what your house looks like.
Yeah.
The stuff.
It's full of DIYs. It's full of DIYs. So what you can see that I've done, and I'll show you just in a second when we cut it out, is I thought it looked really nice to keep this little white border. Not only does it give it a crisp edge, but it actually makes it so much easier to cut out because you're not trying to follow. Exactly. So when you're doing it, all you have to do is try to run your scissors all along, giving yourself an even distance.
Mm.
So you can work your way around, and it ends up looking like it's got a pretty outline, intentional, but it's also much easier.
I also would like to say I love that she's repurposing this little piece of fabric.
Where is that from?
If anyone remembers from last week, Orly did this on the most amazing handbags.
Oh, yeah?
And you know what's really...
Which are now all in the back of my car that she's given to
me. Yes. Debbie took them. They're really cool. So this is a great way to repurpose fabric. But I brought this out here because I wanted to show you. If you look at this hat, do you see how much smaller these leaves are? Remember how big the print was?
Yes, of course.
Okay, so obviously this was way too big. It was just not possible to incorporate. So this is what I did. I took it and I just shaped it out myself.
Oh, adorable.
So I went like this and I worked with the shape and the lines that it has and I created my own smaller custom leaves. So even if you have large floral prints or large things, think about just cutting them into shapes that fit on your hat. So that's just
clever.
Real quick for scale.
Yep.
Will any type of hat work with this project?
Okay, so...
Well, straw, obviously.
Yes, a straw hat is what you're not going to want to do like a wool fedora type hat. You want a straw hat. A tight weave like this is really great if you want to do the Mod Podge technique, which I'm going to show you how I did this here. That's great because it's stiff to begin with and you can paint it on.
Okay.
If you have a hat like this, which is kind of open and woven, if you painted it with Mod Podge, it would seep through and it would also clog up some of these holes. So that's when using something like this, which is almost like an applique, and using either a teeny bit of fabric glue or hand sewing
it
on.
So you could stitch it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You could stitch something like this on because you can go through these holes. And this is a little, you can see it's a little smaller. I made this one for Blake. Look at little Blakey wearing this hat. So it's so cute. I showed it to her. She sat there touching all the flowers and then put it on.
Stop it.
How cute is it? I know. Look at Callie. She's like, we got a photo shoot?
Oh, she's adorable.
It's really, really sweet. So
obviously that one you don't want to Mod Podge over, but will you show us how to do the Mod Podge one?
Yes. So you can see I've done this one. Now, if you end up with a hat that has a really cool...
I love that.
This has
This is like a New Zealand silver fern.
Yes.
So, well, we know. We got this for you. Uh-huh. So at the end of this
I do 2 weeks of research just like Kim Douglas.
Right.
So I knew that.
Yeah.
So I got that. Yeah, exactly. So it has this really cool detail, and I want to work with the detail.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do is this.
Is cover it up?
No. I'm going to work with it. So if you can see, this has a little bit of gold right there.
Yeah.
This actual fabric. So I thought it was really nice. It ties in really well. So what you're going to do is take your Mod Podge. And I
usually love saying Mod Podge.
You just want to
use the cap. I feel like I need to get some now. I don't have any at home.
Watch this. You're going to think we're ruining it, but watch this.
Okay.
Don't be afraid. Look.
So once you decide on your placement and you've got where you want it to go, just lift it up and you're going to add this on. Mod Podge, saying it again, is not only a glue, but it's also a sealant.
So
you're going to do it in two different ways. You're going to do once on the bottom, which is what's going to keep it nice and flat and make sure that it doesn't go anywhere. And then this is the scary part that gives everyone a minor panic attack.
Oh, it's going to ruin.
No.
Right on top.
Because it dries clear.
It's going to, and that's actually just what Debbie's saying there, is that's when you know it's done and it's dry, is it's
clear. And how long does it take to dry?
When it's clear. So it just depends. If it's outside, depends on
so
how much
you
use.
So should I be standing and should I be watching it dry?
Or no, just leave it for an hour.
Yeah.
Leave it for an hour and come back.
An hour.
And you just want to make sure that you get an even coating, because it will dry, like this is going to dry matte. As you can see, this one did. See that blue flower?
Does it dry perfectly matte? Does it help it become waterproof as well?
Actually, that's a great, great thing. This makes it, this is like a sealant that will make it waterproof. So if you end up with a hat, and this is maybe something you're taking on a Love on Safari.
Yeah.
Well, a Love on Safari.
Or,
you know,
or an Amazing Race. I get
your 122nd country that you may be visiting.
Is that going to end up in the back of your car as well?
It's going to end up on your head now.
Oh, I thought it was going to end up in the back of your car like the bags last week.
Exactly.
I'm not sure this is really working.
I honestly think that's
the new hat.
And that's the angle.
That's how you want to wear it.
Phil, it's you.
No, hats are personalized. This is not working.
Well, we'll put Phil on it. What if she engraves Phil on the hat? Or Mod Podges Phil on the hat? Still no?
Still no.
All right, full instructions for this project, you can go to HallmarkChannel.com. Feeling it.